Hello. Hi, Max. Lovely to meet you. How are you? Thank you for coming. Welcome. Does it feel good to be in the city?
Absolutely. I mean, not that I've been in the city. I've been inside rooms talking about the movie. But it's a privilege to be here. It's just such an incredible and important film festival and an amazing city and a central city to the history of film. And it's a city I've shot a film in and that I will always love.
It's such a pleasure to meet you.
You are so sweet. We're so happy to have you.
Thank you for doing this. It's so generous.
Well, I want you to tell the story, right? Don't I? You're taller. You look taller on television, but we're basically the same size.
I'm basically the same.
Congratulations. I don't want to spoil this for people, but I think the idea of what's wrong criminally and what's wrong morally definitely is going to be playing in people's minds watching this, because it is based on a true story. How challenging was that perspective? Because I love the fact that you never crucify any of your characters, because we're all flawed, I guess.
We are all flawed. And I think the film keeps you on the knife's edge against the expectations, the moral presumptions that you bring to it. And then you start watching things shift and get destabilized as you watch it. That was something that was in the script from the beginning, and it just needed a way of framing it, conceiving it, and then having these actors perform it to deliver that to audiences in a way that I think audiences actually have been enjoying that feeling of uncertainty.
Okay, what has Julianne got on you? Five films. Like, is she like, if you don't put me in this next film, watch what happens?
I have tattoos all over my body.
Really?
As tributes to Julianne Moore. No, I mean, look, she came into my life. We came into each other's lives early on in our film careers. And I think we found in each other counterparts to things that we felt, that we loved about movies and storytelling. And that's just been something I've been so lucky to be able to return to time and again.
Feels like things just settled down and now y'all are making a movie.
It's a very complex and human story.
I think it's hard to trust that you're going to represent Gracie as she was.
I'm going to try. Do you remember when you first met?
You came to the pet store looking for a job.
It was summer after sixth grade.
Seventh.
Natalie Portman, Julianne Moore. This is what we needed, and they are quite mischievous, and people are going to love it. Watching them two together, what was that moment like for you?
It was astonishing. I was on the edge of my director's chair watching them, as I think people watching the film are on the edge of their seats. And then we found this actor to play opposite them, Charles Melton. And man, what a job that he nailed in this film. We're so lucky. The film owes so much to Charles's performance.
What would make a 36-year-old woman have an affair with a seventh grader?
People, they like see me as a victim. I wanted it.
I'm so glad you're here, but I'm missing the actors. I'm so happy for the writers, but hey, I want everyone back. What are your hopes?
It'll get resolved soon. It's a necessary process that we've had to go through. People need to be paid fairly and remunerated fairly for their work. And it's a changing technology, so we always have to figure out how to catch up to it.
Why would you want to play someone who you think is a bad person?
It's the moral gray areas that are interesting.
She's getting on my last nerve. She does everywhere I look.
Why can't we talk about it? If we're really as in love as we say we are?
Insecure people are very dangerous, aren't they?